Grangerino. Elderberry harvest, part two. So if you've been watching the series, all one part of it, you'll see that we had a good time picking a lot of berries. And I said, there's more to come. So today I'm gonna show you how you start the processing after the picking. Now, this, my friends, is a paper sack. And you're saying to yourself, what's it gonna pull out of the bag, a rabbit? No, the rabbit comes out of a hat. Out of the bag comes elderberries, all right? So these have been in the freezer. And sorry, I'm 6'7". I gotta kinda crouch down so I can get the camera here. Let me see if I can fix that. How's that, a little better? All right. So these have been in the freezer. And why you say the freezer? Well, as you remember, and if you know anything about elderberries, they come in these big clusters. And they're all attached by fine little stems. Great big umbels, if you recall. And you need to get each one of those little berries off those stems. You don't want the stems. I mean, the stems are bitter and that sort of thing. But when you freeze them, they come peeling off pretty doggone easy. Not too bad at all. Now, paper sack's not the strongest thing in the world, so you don't want to go crazy with it. But you can just reach right in here and start to crumble. You can hear them. I mean, I got them coming off by the thousands right now. All good stuff. And see that? All stems now. Pretty much free of berries. So you lose a couple maybe in the process if you aren't overly thorough, but don't let that bother you. I mean, it's kind of an easy come, easy go situation here, but you got to get them all off the stems, and you got to get the stems out of play. And I just work it over rather quickly, and I can get just handfuls of stems out, you know, nothing but stem really. And lots of perfect little berries down inside here next, remaining. So I just use my fingers to essentially comb the berries off and strain the stems out. And what you have left is pure berry. Lots of them. They add up pretty quickly. Now, you saw me picking 5 gallon pails. The 5 gallon pails pretty much equate to a good solid 1 gallon, maybe a little more, probably a strong 1 gallon of clean berries when it's all said and done. So I'm just working these over really quickly. You can see this is essentially a good half a 5 gallon pail crushed in here. And it's cleaning up rather quickly right now. There's not a lot of stemmage left. I've got the vast majority out of play already. So I'll just continue to work this quickly. I don't want to bore you with the detail of straining it out, but you can see if you don't freeze these and you try to take all the berries off the stems otherwise, it's pretty difficult. We've tried using a comb and stripping them by finger and that sort of thing. This, my friends, is an incredible time saver. This really works well. So I've strained a lot of the stemmage out. See if I can turn this here so you can see it. Hang on. I've strained a lot of the stems out by hand. Now you can see almost pure berry. I want to work somewhat quickly because the berries are quite small, and they will thaw somewhat quickly as well, which can be a little bit of a trick, just trying to stay ahead of that thaw. But like I said, it's very, very easy to work through this. Pull the stems out, get the vast majority. I don't go for 100%, little bit of stemage never killed anybody. So we get a few stems left in here, no big deal. I'm also looking for like Japanese beetles or aphids or something that can create some unnecessary protein in the final product. So just come on, sort through quick, grab the bigger stems and get it to the point where you've got it pretty well stem free. I turn it over by hand a little bit to kind of sift again. You can see the tiny, tiny, tiny little stems that stick. No big deal. They're a dime a dozen. But those elderberries are small, little BBs, but they're highly potent. If you watch my last video, part one, one thing I neglected to say was that the nutritional value of elderberries is found in the description. It's a pretty impressive list. Like I said, Hippocrates, the father of medicine from Greece back in, you know, 500 AD or whatever it was, looked at elderberries as one of the most important parts of his quote-unquote medicine chest. So he knew what he was getting into back there. We know what we're getting into even more so now, and good stuff. Like I say, it's really quite easy to do. There's not a lot to this. I'm just about done, I'd say. And now, they're still hard, they're still frozen. You see they're getting a little bit moist, picking up some condensation here, but no big deal. I still got some time, trying to get a little bit more detail out of it, and then I'll show you how I get them into a Ziploc bag with relative ease as well. But like I say, take it to the cleanliness level you want. You see, I'm not obsessive compulsive about this. It's get it where you can and take it the rest of the way, you'll be fine. Probably adds even more nutrition for all we know with a little bit of stem in there. But just get the big chunks. I'm seeing no bugs in this batch at all. We've only found the bugs to be more of a problem if you've got wild grapes growing next to the berries. How's that? Look at that, my friends. That is gold, black gold, Texas tea. Y'all come back now, you hear? That's a joke from the Beverly Hillbillies for those of you that are young. But that's good stuff. Here we go. Hang on. Okay, if you don't have one of these little contraptions, I suggest you buy one. Called a Ziploc bag holder. I got it on Amazon. I'm not into all that links and promo and stuff, but you just take your Ziploc like this, hook it on one side in the middle, hook it on the other side in the middle, holds the bag out. There's even a suction cup on here if you really wanted to work at that, but there you go. Now I can single-handedly take these and just gently pour them in the Ziploc bag. Now, I'd like to shake it in a little bit. Settle down in the corners, etc., etc., and do the final pour here. You see, some of the finer stemmage stays in there as well, and that helps too. Now, these residual berries on the stems and everything that I'm going to discard, I will discard in such a way that hopefully I can propagate my own patch right in the backyard here out by my garden. But I've neglected to do that for a while. Now, there you go. Beautiful gallon Ziploc full of clean elderberries, ready to go into the now kind of the rendering process, if you will, or whatever you want to call it, making the juice that will be the working backbone of everything going forward. So that's step two. Freeze everything in a paper sack. We compress them in, get a lot in there, throw it in the freezer for at least a day. It wouldn't keep it a whole lot longer. Don't have to. They freeze quickly. And then, like I say, you just sort out all the stems. You've got your beautiful final berries in the gallon Ziplocs. That gallon Ziploc will go back in the freezer, pull it out, and I'll cover that in part three. But this is the intermediate step of handling the elderberries that you need to understand. Now, we're having fun. I'm looking at these berries, these bags of berries, and licking my chops, saying there's good stuff ahead. There is some good product coming my way, and it's been extremely simple. I had a great time in the ditch, picking the berries, having fun, listening to the birds, spot a skeeter maybe, but got it collected, no problem. Put them in a paper sack, froze them, pulled them back out. What'd it take me here? 10 minutes, I got everything ready to go. You got the same thing going. We'll take you in part three and how we're gonna render this down into the juice base. And I hope you're enjoying all this, because I'm telling you what, I'm living life full, large, and simple. Elderberries. Check out the description in my, whatever they call that up there. You know, I'm not the best YouTube guy in the world. I'm just a simple old schmo out here in the woods, having fun, like I say, living life large, full, and simple, trying to impart some knowledge to you that you may or may not already have. Hopefully you find it entertaining. Hopefully you find it fun. Hopefully you find it satisfying and useful. And if you do, by God, please subscribe and like and do all that stuff. And if you don't, oh well, I can't do much about that either. But I really appreciate all those of you who do watch. And I ask you to keep watching. Send me a comment. I really like comments. Give me a comment. Give me ideas. Tell me what you want to see next. Sky's the limit, really. I do all sorts of crazy stuff out here. But this is Elderberry Harvest Part 2. Until next time, Ranger Reno, over and out.